Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. We are expecting to learn more about a threat that led to the closure of all Nashua schools today at a press conference this afternoon. The threat came in the form of an email. The superintendent in Nashua got it Sunday morning. Police are not giving specifics about what it said, but the superintendent says that it was very detailed and that the high schools in Nashua appear to be the targets. Nashua police, along with FBI agents, are investigating this and trying to determine if this was a credible threat and who may be responsible. In light of recent events across the country, the superintendent didn't want to take any chances. So rather than just close the high schools, he determined that it was safest for all students to stay home. And two private schools also closed for the day.
We made the decision last night to err on the side of caution, based on the fact it was a very specific threat to both of our high schools. And it noted today as a specific date that the action would occur, along with the means for how students would be harmed.
Now, next door to Nashua and Hudson, the superintendent there says he has increased police presence at the schools today just as a precaution. Well, nine businesses were left without water today after a sinkhole was discovered in Manchester. The sinkhole was reported just after 6 this morning. A police cruiser in the drive-through lane fell right into it. We did get a picture of that. The City Water Works Department tells News 9 that they were notified and they shut off the water supply just before 8 a.m. But because the issue is on private property, the city does not get involved with the repair. A multi-state police pursuit has ended with one person dead. It happened just after 7 last night in Seabrook. State police were notified of a Massachusetts police pursuit on 95 that was headed into New Hampshire. Troopers deployed spike strips to stop the 1999 Ford Explorer, but it continued for another 3/4 of a mile before hitting the center median and a guardrail. 35-year-old Jeffrey Hiltz of Danvers, Mass. Was pronounced dead at the scene. It's unclear why he was fleeing from police. Governor Maggie Hassan is calling for a full investigation into Liberty Utilities after a carbon monoxide emergency in Keene over the weekend. A problem at a production plant caused the company to send pure propane to more than 1,200 customers, exposing them to potentially high levels of carbon monoxide.
It's really, really important that all of our gas systems work and are safe, and that's what we want to focus on right now.
A spokesman for Liberty Utilities says that they have been communicating with the Public Utilities Commission throughout the emergency, and they expected the governor to call for this investigation. Starting tonight at 5 o'clock, a former lottery official already accused of scamming one state is now under investigation by several more. The game at the center of a scheme is played right here in New Hampshire. And we're going to have much more on the threat that closed Nashua schools today. You can use our mobile app and WMUR.com for new developments throughout the day. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.